Hello, Shaggy SoCal Tour for Forza, and this is track guide for Hockenheim Ring Short for TNT39, the Porsche Macan. It'll be the second track that we're racing next Thursday. Not sure if this will be the first race or the second race, but again, both at Hockenheim Ring. Again, previous track guide was for the National Circuit, which, you know, the short has a lot of the same elements, but there are some subtle things that on this track that you know, if you using some static references that are going to change. So my intentions are as far as trying to get the Porsche around the track, and then I'll do a mock race to kind of put that into practice with some questionable racecraft, and we'll see how it goes. So Under the test drive. So again, you know, turn one is going to be pretty much what you're going to be doing on for the National Circuit. I think the difference will be is you don't have as many additional references to look at. Wait, the turn in there. That niche. Gonna do that out lap, because this isn't gonna take too long to go through. Sorry, I've got two cats demanding attention. One just decided that he's had enough of me. He's going to walk across the chair and flick his tail in my nose, and then leave the room. Doesn't help at setting fast laps. Okay, so do the slow lap. Turn one, it's going to be the same philosophy. You're going to be in fourth gear. You're going to downshift to third, you know, to get through turn one. And again, as I talked about on the Hockenheim National, to me, I always look at this as threading a needle, because you want to use a little bit of that inside curb if you can. You want to carry enough speed through so you can carry that onto the straight. But, you know, if you go too far to the inside, it's going to unsettle the portion. It's going to push you wide. You might get a time penalty. If you carry too much speed and you're late, you're going to go wide. So it is, you know, to get it consistently right is always going to be a challenge. But the other thing I want to point out, and this is kind of one of those things in Forza, I don't know why they did this. I'm hoping, you know, for the next Forza Motorsport, that stuff like this, we have some consistency between the layouts. If you notice on the left-hand side, what don't you see? There's no braking markers. And to me, at least for this, I mean, for any of the circuits, I mean, this turn, no matter which layout we're using, is always going to be the same turn one. You're going to be carrying the same speed, whether it's the full circuit, you know, national or short. You know, they should have the braking boards on the left side. So, unfortunately, they don't. So there's that additional reference that you don't have. You know, for me, again, to correlate with the braking line, it's going to be just as you get into, you know, it's just as you start getting onto the curbing. If you can't see the braking line at all, just know that once you start seeing blue, you better get on the brakes. The braking point is somewhere about halfway between where, you know, as far as the braking line, it's somewhere about halfway between where that curbing starts, that blue and white curbing starts, and the corner worker shack there, the blue and white. So it's somewhere in here. You might want to maybe use the megaphone there that's just under the rearview mirror if you want to try and look that far ahead for it. But mainly, I think for me, it's always keeping an eye on where does this curbing start. And nope, I'm not going to get that. probably, let's see, who is it? Okay. The fetching Mrs. Shaggy Silkel got it. It's probably for her anyway. But yeah, it's somewhere about here, you know, where the curving starts, but you know, definitely before you get to the corner worker shack. So drop it down to third. And turn in point's gonna be about the same. So when I talked about on the National is I'm kind of using where this access road meets the track as kind of the reference point, having that in my peripheral so that I can turn my eyes towards the corner apex. And it's really kind of releasing the brakes here and still in third gear, off the gas, and I'll roll back into the throttle here. And if I've done it right, I'll barely come out, maybe just bounce off the curving there, exiting turn one. Still in third gear. You're not going to be able to get to fourth since this is a much shorter straightaway. It's going to be much harder. I don't know that you can really set up a proper pass. I think if you're going to make a pass into here, it's mainly because you've gotten a really good exit out of the previous corner, and the guy you're trying to pass didn't. So heading up into here, and again, because for whatever reason on the short circuit they decide that you don't need, we don't need braking boards. Who needs additional references? What I'm going to point out, braking for this next turn, I don't know, slide it up here. What seems to line up with the braking line is that patch flowers. That, if you can get your eyes to spot that as you're coming out of turn one and heading up in there, and again, it's just, you want to just get it spotted and get it in peripheral so that you can keep your focus forward. But those flowers actually line up with the braking where it goes red. So if you can't see the braking line, look for those flowers. That's the best reference point I can find. So this is a second gear corner. And again, turn in for me is you're going to turn in probably right about here, right about before you hit the edge of the red there. Yeah, I don't have a specific turn-in point, mainly to get the car slowed down and get it down into second. But I do take this as kind of like, and it's very similar to the turn for the normal circuit, the late apexer in second gear. And, you know, as soon as you get past, let me back it up here a little bit, and you can play around with this as you guys do your laps. But I think for me, as soon as I'm getting past this white curbing on the inside here, yeah, I'm trying to get back to full throttle as soon as possible. And, you know, again, at this point, you've got there. I don't have any definitive, like, this is the proper line or this is the fastest line. Traffic's going to determine that as well. But generally, you know, once I get back to full throttle, again, the Porsche is going to understeer a little bit. So I'm going to let it understeer and probably bring it out to about the middle. And then kind of cut in here, maybe get onto the blue thing, you know, the curving there on the inside, all the way up third gear. Let's see, second gear, third gear, fourth gear. And now we're getting into the next set of turns to kind of get back on the proper circuit for the stadium section. There's a couple different, in my own playing, there's a couple different ways you can approach this. I've actually, and figure out which works for you. There's, you can let off early and get the Porsche turned in, get it online, and then roll back in. You can stay on the throttle on entry, and just before you get to the, and then maybe halfway between entry and apex, you know, crack the throttle a little bit to get to the apex and then roll back in. Or you can charge in full throttle, and just to get the apex, you quick let off the throttle and get the back end to help rotate the Porsche out. Up to you, whichever is most comfortable to you. But ultimately you'll arc it in here. And again, this curving on the inside is very Porsche friendly. So I will late apex it and I'll cross over. I'll use a bit of that if I can, just so that it lines me up and it gives me a kind of a straighter line into this next, I want to call it a chicane, but the next corner setting up for the turn back onto the main circuit. But I'll come out of here, third gear, I think, still no, fourth gear still. Still be fourth gear, heavy braking. And what I'm trying to do is I'm lining up the Porsche because I'm going to clip the inside curb here. But I'm looking, if you can look straight ahead, and you see the Xbox One logos on the gantry there. I'm kind of aiming for that left one because you can see how I'm lined up. It kind of lines up pretty well, you know, from where I'm at right now to the curbing to that sign. And that's to help me kind of set, because I'm going to do my braking in a straight line and then release the brakes and turn, and that'll get me to the second half of the turn onto the back onto the circuit. So it'll probably look something like brake, 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 brake. I might turn slightly, so I'm kind of lining up there. It also kind of lines up with the end of the blue and white curbing, painted curbing here on the left, and where the cones are, which, guaranteed, we're going to take those cones out during the race. But brake, 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 brake. And then right about here is where I'll be releasing the brake to turn in for the next corner. You can see it opens this up very nicely to have a nice line back onto the circuit. It also, because you're doing a wide, I'm cutting and then I'm going way wide to make this. You know, if you're in close traffic, someone might take a shot and take a lunge down the inside. So just be mindful of who's behind you and then how wide you want to, you know, exit out to here for this next corner. So I was trying to do this in third gear. I actually think second's going to work best to get out of here. So second gear, you know, clip a little bit of that curbing up to third. Actually, let's see. Second, third. I'm trying to remember that outlap I just did. It shows my short-term memory. I'm getting old. Definitely third gear. I think it's one of those, if you wind out in second, then it's a choice of, let me back it up here a little bit. It's that choice of, if you leave it in second, you're going to be banging the rev limiter right about when you're going to be needing to kind of turn in for this, you know, turn in for the stadium section. Now in the national circuit, we're carrying a lot more speed into here. So I think we're, you know, up into fourth gear or high third gear, fourth gear, you know, and it's a third through here. You won't be able to take it flat. You are going to have to balance the throttle a little bit. So I think this one, I mean, for me, I'll probably then figure out what works best for me as I get in and run a whole bunch of laps in the mock race. But, again, you can either leave it in third and then, you know, as you turn in, you know, upshift to you know, leave it in second, upshift to third on turn in. Like when you release the throttle to turn the Porsche in, you know, pop it up to third and then just balance the throttle through the corner. If you want to short shift to third, again, when you let off, you might have to give a dab a brake, but you'll definitely be, at least for me on the controller, again, I tend to balance more with the throttle since I don't have quite the precise steering that the wheel users do. But again, first gear. There we go. But turn in is going to be like between this white sign. You're not carrying as much speed in. So I'm finding that I'm turning, you know, as far as letting off and turning in right about where this whiteboard here is. I don't know what's on the other side. And again, on the national circuit, because we're carrying more speed. So it's somewhere, it's that speaker system or whatever that is. I'm guessing that's a speaker system. So it's going to be somewhere between, you know, the whiteboard and then the speakers there. The third gear, and again, this is kind of back to what we did on National. So late apex, let it come all the way out, start bringing it back, wind it up in third gear, green tires go by, down to second, turn in. Again, I tend to be a little above the white line and then late apex it, roll back in, second gear, third gear. You can use a bunch of this curving if you get the line right. Stay off that one there. Brake just as you pass that access road. You don't have to go, and I don't go all the way out to the left. I tend to keep it like halfway, maybe a little bit to the left, an entry. And again, I've been doing this in third gear, though my bad habit, sometimes I'll downshift it to second. I think for pit entry, you're going to want to downshift to second, because then that's going to help you pull the car to the right, you know, to cut that turn to get into pit lane, and I'll test that in the race. I did it in third on National and almost took out the green tires. So again, third gear, bring it all the way out. You can cross over you can get on the curving here a little bit. But then I'm finding turn in for me, if you do it right, you're going to be turning in just before you get to where that, you know, that red painted asphalt is for the drag strip. So you'll turn it in late in third gear. And then back on the front stretch. That's Hockenheim short. I mean, it's very, you know, a lot of the same elements we had on National. It's just going to be that crossover infield section that's the new element. And where I'm probably expecting a lot of, what I'm expecting a lot of side-by-side racing, probably, you know, some incidental contact and maybe even some Forza glue, you know, if front fenders get on rear quarter panels. But with that, let's go ahead and finish the test drive and let's do a mock race. By my guesstimate, you know, it's a shorter circuit. It's about, at least I'm in the 112. So if I round up to 113 and 35 minute race, it's around 28 laps. So I don't know if that's what we'll actually be doing or not. And I just want to make sure. Yep, I still have quick stops on. Same classes as I did last night on the National. So I'll still be doing A, R, and S Porsches. And hopefully, I don't get taken out by the leader out of fifth place because he was going to put us a lap down. But let's go ahead and get started. It's that MoMA Porsche that was the culprit yesterday. Again, we'll give them a 40-second head start. Have these guys starting about 20 seconds behind me. And I would suspect they're going to catch me within... These guys are going to catch me probably within two laps. Sometimes the nice thing too is you release the brakes and turn in for turn one, the back end of the Macan will just ever, that back end's just gonna ever so slightly rotate. All right, so let me just charge into the corner this time. Charge in, let off. And it brings me a little bit wide. I think third gear is going to be better to get into third before you get to that corner. Just hear the left rear there just starting to lose grip. They're telling me that it's about... Oh, somebody's pitting already. Okay, heading up to here. Bought the flowers. I think on my own, just cracking the throttle as I turn in, that's going to be the best. Probably cut that a little more than I wanted to. So yeah, I'm upshifting at the whiteboard on the left for turn in. That's probably going to be the best way to do that. But again, track guide's mainly just me to show you what I do, what I look at, what I think about. You can decide whether that works for you or not. It's all about just giving you as much info as possible. 12, 9. That's a little bit late, going a little wide. Very easy, so easy to go wide. So it looks like my turn in, where I'm releasing the brakes for turn two, is right as I'm crossing the white timing line that goes across the track there. So pay attention to that next time. Then the braking for that correlates with the blue and white curving, where it starts on the left side for that again, I'm just pointing out additional references, and this is things that as you guys are running laps, just kind of open your vision up a little bit and like, all right, I tend to be braking here. What landmarks are around that kind of correlates with where I'm braking in case I, you know, can't track the braking line and need some other reference. Four laps. Look for the curving on the left side there. I need to brake on the turn in. Okay, I was looking for the crossover, but he got on the binders a lot more than I was expecting. I was expecting a little more of a lunge. Oh, ooh, they missed the barrier. That was a little early. Take another look. He's gonna take a look. Let's see if he gets it done this time. Nope. Did I go off track again? Oh no, they kept it on that time. Oh, he's got a big head of steam this time. Nope, he's gonna back off. There's just not enough straightaway for him to take advantage of his top end advantage. What I'm going to do is I'm going to go a little more defensive this time just to see what the AI does. Bring it out. I'm going to bring it across a little bit, right about there. What are you going to do? Big fat ton in front of you. On the car. Look at the car. fully defensive. He's gonna figure out. He's gonna get it right, and he's gonna get by me at some point. Just don't want to compromise too much of my pace. He does. There he goes. Now I think he's got the run now. There you go. Nice job. Wow. I was looking for the crossover because he was so far to the inside, but he decided to park it on the apex. That was early on the turn in. Oh, we've got the pink pig joining the party. He's just gonna rocket by me here. No, he is indecisive. Outside? I did a little bit of a extra braking just to make sure I didn't push wide into him. I was hoping some more of the blue guys would hit or a little more traffic to work with early. Ooh, yeah, see? That cut it a little too much there. And it just put me wide. It's kind of, I think, what I said, you know, in the previous one is you can use a little bit of that turn one curbing. You know, try and stay off the orange and a little late into that corner. Move inside. But I know I'm a big fat Porsche Macan, but you're not gonna get that much draft off of me. I'm gonna leave left side open. There you go, and he still almost runs me off the road. There when I lifted into the that initial right hander, that I could feel the back end just start to rotate just that little bit. Are you gonna do that? Oh, that was a questionable rejoin. think per usual, I'll pit about halfway, and we'll see where we wind up in traffic. I got on the orange again, but at least that time, it kicked the rear of the car around a little bit. Gave me just that wee bit extra rotation. A little bit late on the turn in there. A little bit early on the turn in there. You get to see all the things that I do wrong. You can see you can use a little bit more, like, you know, on the national circuit, because you're carrying so much speed down that straight for this turn into the stadium section. I really don't stray over the white line as much to make that left-hander, but I think, try that again next lap, but I think you can probably get away with doing a little bit of that on the short circuit, since you're kind of almost making this really nice big grand arc out of that infield crossover to that stadium right-hander. One big arc. Green tires, don't hit the green tires. This is a little bit better. Okay, well, at this point, we'll probably come out in last place again, and it's just a question of how many guys do I get on the undercut? How many people do I have to pass on to? Well, I'm not going to be quite last, but looks like a leader's coming up as well. So again, stay to the right of the white line. The traffic's clear once you... Well, actually, not like the other one. You can just stay to the right. All right. setting up a little wider because I'm just not sure what the closure speed's going to be on this Porsche coming onto the front straight. Okay, yeah, he's got more straight lines. So we'll look to do the crossover on exit here. Could carry more speed up through here. A little too wide on entry there. I'm at that point in the race where it's like, oh, I'd like to set a quick, clean lap, but I don't know if traffic's going to let me do that. I at least have a 12.6. There might be more in there than that. But I'm not close enough to take advantage. Might be able to get a little bit of run out of here. Not enough. Oh, there we go. Nope. I'll take that. So, there again, it's like I could have tried to force the pass into one, but, you know, given traffic, I just back out a little bit, get a slightly better exit out, and then have a better chance of passing it. But again, I'm competing with essentially a track car. Even if I get a really good exit out, he's got the horsepower advantage. Or that's, I'm forcing that one. Even that one's, it's questionable to try and stuff a pass in there because you have to compromise your mid-corner speed so much to make it work. Oops. Sorry, I forget slow shifting. And a little room just in case, but he backed out of it. Looking at the track map to see just what I had coming up in front of me. I try and pass him. He does here. I can undercut it. Nope. I'll just try and set up for the run down into this corner. Can't see him, so I'll leave a little room. Okay, there it is. Okay, 8 laps left. Also, I'm actually keeping a much closer eye on how far behind I am with the leader. I don't want to get caught in a situation where I get rammed by the leader because they've already finished the race and the AI goes completely insane. Same situation. Oh no, can't take advantage. Guys, all sorts of room. Okay, so it looks like just a bunch of... Later did hit, so... Figuring out how to get past... Almost cut that too much. But this point is, again, it's slower traffic, so I know I'm quicker. It's just, where am I quicker, and how do I set the pass up? And again, it's easier for me in this because there is differences that can be exploited, whereas in the Porsche, we're all driving the same thing. Not gonna have it here. I want to see if I can get him on exit. Almost did that right. But I've got inside position. Make sure I don't push out into him. Have to compromise that corner. We're gonna set him up at my favorite place to dive bomb people. You gotta get a decent exit, so I don't think I can do it. Ooh, but he goes wide. I'm wide, a little room, but ooh, that was a very early turn in. Again, they're just spaced out enough where I'm not going to get a clean left. And I'm not going to run. I'm not going to back off just to, like, try and do a quali lap at the very end. It is what it is. Now that I think the quickest, I'm flirting with being able to get into the 111s, but excuse me. That you want to be careful for as well, coming out of that that corner. If you got somebody to your right, now try and leave as much room as you can without compromising your line, because it's pretty easy to hip check them off the track. Excuse me, pardon me, pardon me, excuse me. Like that. I was leaving a little bit of racing room. And again, I had to lift a little bit just to make sure I could make the last corners. .12.9 was my best clean lap. see. It was 2/10 up at the only split. 7/8. It's like a 1/12/1. So 1/12/1/4/8. So again, I guess bucket five, you know, it wouldn't surprise me to see you know, Sue or Hitman, you know, or me if I'm on that race, but and definitely Dan probably be able to get into the 111s with that. So that's Hockenheim short. Again, you know, some references that you had at National you don't have here. And this is going to be another track going to be very difficult to pass. So it's really just going to be, you know, being patient, look for mistakes, and also kind of judge where you're quicker and where you're not, and how you know, and how best to set up a run so you can take advantage. So with that, I'm going to call it a day here for this. I hope you guys have a great weekend. I'll see you on Thursday. Happy racing.